Hello all, welcome to Netbook. Today I'm planning to talk about how we can sign up for the GitHub and how we can create a repository in the GitHub. That is what I'm going to show. Go to that github.com. Over here, you can see that there is a sign in and sign up. The first time you need to sign up, click on sign up. Over here you can see that enter your email ID. We need to enter our email ID. I'm going to enter netbookforblog@gmail.com. And then click on continue. Over here, I need to create a password. I'm going to create a password over here and then click on continue. Then we need to enter some username. I'm going to enter some username, netbookforblog, and then click on continue. Over here, would you like to receive a product updates and announcements via email? If you want yes, then you can enter Y. If you don't want, you can click on, you enter N. I'm going to enter Y and click on continue. If you see this page is something different, another website sign in page, this is very interesting, right? Now you can see that to verify your account. So we need to solve some fuzzle over here. Start fuzzle. Here pick a spiral galaxy. The spiral galaxy we need to select. I'm going to select over here the spiral and click on create account. Now there will be one email will be sent it to this email ID. We need to enter the verification code. Let me log into the email. If you see that there is an email from the GitHub, select that. And over here I can see there is a verification code. I can copy that and enter over here. That's it. Now we logged into the GitHub. We signed up for the GitHub. So I can click on skip presentation. And it is initializing our dashboard. So this is how we can sign up for the GitHub. The next thing is, once the GitHub is ready, we can create a repository where you can store your project code. Now, if you want to create a repository, either you can click on over here, create repository, or from here, new repository you can do. So what I can do is, I can create a repository name over here. I can say this Salesforce API. So this is the system API for the Salesforce in the MuleSoft. So that is what I want to store my code under this repository. So I'm going to give this project repository name over here. Then you need to select either it is a public repository or private repository. If it is organization, you need to select a private repository. And if you have some blogger and all, if you have done some coding and all, you want to share with the public, then you can select as a public over here. Then you can keep some description about this project also. That is what you can write it, but that is optional. And if you want to initialize the readme file, gitignore files, the readme file is about your project details, like what is about this repository and the changes, whatever the release versions and all, if you are going to update it, you can update it in the readme file. So it is kind of a about your project. So when you select gitignore, what files you need to ignore and all, you need to specify over here. Okay, so I'm going to uncheck this also, then click on create repository. That's it. This is the repository which is created over here, and now we can store the source code under this repository. And if you want to create a project under the GitHub, you can go over here and I'm going to say new project over here. I can say the project name is MuleSoft for Digital. So if you are going to build any MuleSoft applications for this project, you are going to say that for the digital, you are going to implement some MuleSoft project. So I'm going to keep it that name, and you can keep some description about this project. And if you have some templates and all, you can select. And again, similarly, visibility for everybody, if you want to say, then you can select public, or if it is organization, you can keep it as a private. And you can link the repositories. I just created a repository, right? That is the repository is this Salesforce API. We can link the repositories also. Then click on create project. That's it. So we can see that over here, the project has been created. This is my project. And at that, we can hope that is clear. So how to create a repository, how to create a project, That is what we have discussed right now in this project, in this video. That's it for today. Thank you for watching this video. Please like, share, subscribe.